Hey everyone, welcome back to our series on relational algebra. So far we've covered some of the fundamental operations like select, project, union, set difference, Cartesian product. In today's video, we are going to dive into the first derived operation, that is intersection operation. Before we get into relational algebra, let's quickly recall what intersection means in set theory. If we have two sets, set A has 1, 2, 3 and set B has 2, 3 and 4. So if we take the intersection of set A and B, what do we get? It will contain all the elements that are present in both sets A and B. That is the common elements. Now here we have 1, but here we don't have 1. So 1 will be eliminated. Here we have 2. Here also we have 2. So the intersection of A and B will contain 2. Then here we have 3. Here also we have 3. So A intersection B will contain 3. Now here we have no more elements, but here we have 4. So it will be eliminated. So it contains all the elements that are common in both the sets. Now in relational algebra, we apply a similar concept, but instead of the sets, we are using the relations or the tables, right? Since intersection requires two sets, we also need two relations. And thus, intersection operation is a binary operator. It is denoted by this symbol here, which looks like an inverted U. Next. In relational algebra, the intersection operation is used to find the common tuples between two relations. This means the output will contain only the rows that are present in both the relations. Let's look at the general syntax for intersection of two relations. Let's say the relations are R and S. So the intersection of R and S will be R intersection S. And if you're dealing with specific columns in two relations, the syntax would be something like this. We know that when we're talking about columns, when we're taking particular columns, we use the projection operation. So we start with projecting the column of a particular relation and we again take the column of another relation and then we take the intersection of both. So first we project the columns from both the relations. This column is from the relation R. This column is from the relation S. And then we are taking the intersection of both of these columns. I hope that this was clear. It will be clearer when we take the example. But before that, let's discuss some conditions that are mandatory to perform intersection operation. Just like we discussed in union and set difference, for intersection also, it is important that both the relations must have same number of columns. This is when we are performing the intersection of two relations, not specific columns of two relations. When we are performing intersection of two relations, it is must that both the relations must have equal number of columns, which is also known as the same arity. That means both the relations must have the same arity. The second condition says that the corresponding columns, that means from both the relations, whichever columns we are taking for intersection, those columns must belong to the same data domain. That means the data types of both of these columns must match. If both the columns belong to integer data type, then they can be intersected. If both the columns are characters, then the intersection will be possible. But if one column has the data type as integers and the other column has the data type as characters, then the intersection will not be possible. Let's start with the first example. Let's say we have two relations, relation A and relation B. Both of these relations have a single column. This has ID 101, 102, 103. This also has ID 101, 103, 104, 106 and 109. Now we know that when we perform the intersection, only the common tuples in both the columns will be taken in the output, right? Now let's check which are the common tuples in both the columns. So that means this row will be present in the output. Next we have 102, but here we don't have 102 anywhere, right? So that means this row will not be present in the output. Again, here we have 103 and here also we have 103. That means this row will be present in the output. Now, do we need to check all of these? No, because obviously they won't be present in relation A because there are no more tuples left in relation A. So the output will contain only two rows, 101 and 103. So when we take the intersection, that is A intersection B, we get 101 and 103 as the output. Alright, this was a very simple example. Now another interesting thing to note is that A intersection B can also be represented as something else. We have studied set difference. And an important thing to note is that set difference is kind of opposite to intersection, right? In set difference, what do? We take the tuples that are present in the first relation but are not present in the second relation. Here we are taking the common tuples, right? In that case, we used to take only the tuples that were present in the first relation but were not present in the second relation, right? Like for example here, if I take A minus B, what will I get? 101 and 101 will be eliminated because they are common in both. 102 will be present in the output. 103 will also be eliminated because they are common in both, right? So set difference is kind of opposite to the intersection operation. So we can use set difference to also perform the intersection. That is, if we wish to perform intersection without using the intersection operation, we can do that by using the set difference. Let's see how we can do that. Let's start with taking A minus B, right? So here I've already shown you how we get A minus B. 102 is the only tuple that is present in relation A. 101 and 103 are also present in relation B, so they will be eliminated in A minus B, right? Now, after taking A minus B, we take A minus B. So we are taking the set difference between relation A and relation A minus B. Now see here, we have 101. It is present here, but it is not present here. That means this row will be present in the output. 102 is present here. It is also present here. So this row will not be present in the output. 103 is present here, but it is not present here. So then 103 will also be present in the output. And this is our output, 101 and 103, which is same as A intersection B. 101, 103. Alright? So if we have to perform the intersection of two relations without using the intersection operation, we can do it like this. First relation minus first relation minus second relation. Alright? I hope that this was clear. Now let's take a slightly more complex example. Suppose we have two relations with different number of columns, right? See, until now it was possible to perform intersection here because both of these had same number of columns and it also had the same domain. But now in this case, the number of columns, that is the arity, is different and the columns also have different domains. So to perform the intersection of these two relations directly will not be possible. We cannot directly perform A intersection B. That is not possible. So what are we going to do? We are going to take a particular column from both the relations and perform the intersection. Let's say we have to perform the intersection on the department column. Okay, we know that when we are taking the intersection of two columns, First, we need to project those columns. So first, we are taking the column department from the relation A, and then we are taking the department column from relation B, and then we are performing the intersection of both of these columns, right? Let's see which tuples will be available in the output. Here we have IT, and here also we have IT. So IT will be present in the output. Here we have HR, again here we have HR. So HR will be present in the output. Now here we have IT, but we've already taken IT, and finance is not present in both of these columns, and thus it will be eliminated. So output will have only two tuples, IT and HR. Let's take the next example, which is based on a college database. We have to list all the students. That means we have to give the names of all the students who are also professors from the IT department who have joined in the year 2024. So we have two tables here, students table and the professors table. We need to give the names of all the students who are also the professors. So intersection will be performed on these columns, the name columns from both the tables, right? But the condition is the department has to be IT. So this, and this. We are going to intersect it on the basis of the department. Also, another condition is they must have joined in the year 2024. So this student, and this student has joined in 2024, and these two professors have joined in the year 2024. Now, first thing that we will have to do is we will have to select the rows. And we know that when we are selecting the rows, we use the select operation, that is sigma. But which rows will be selected from the students table? The students who are in the IT department and they have also joined in the year 2024. See, we are not talking about the final output right now. We are just talking about the select operation. Okay. And here Clara, she is in HR and she joined in 2023. So she won't be present in the selected rows. So for the select condition, what do we have? We are selecting all the students whose department is IT. I'm writing in short. Okay. And the second condition is they have joined in the year 2024. So this is also a mandatory condition. So we're going to use the logical and. Year joined is going to be 2024. So this is the condition for both students as well as the professors. Now, after we've selected these rows from the students as well as the professors table, we only need the column name, right? So we are going to project, that is use pi and project only the column name for both students and professors. And then we are going to take the intersection of both. See, when we are projecting the names, we have John and Bob from the students table and John and Bob from the professors table. Right? And when we take the intersection, both the columns have these two tuples, right? That means these both are the common tuples in both the columns, and thus both of them will be present in the output. Let's look at the output. Here's the output, John and Bob. So what have we done here? First, we have selected the rows in both the tables. From the students table, we are taking the students whose department is IT and who have joined in the year 2024. Same for the professors table, we are selecting department IT and joined in the year 2024. And we are projecting the name columns of both. And finally, we are taking the intersection and we've received our output. I hope that this was clear. So, intersection operation is a binary operation because it requires two relations. And out of those two relations, only the common tuples appear in the output. Another condition is both the columns that are being intersected must have same number of columns and they must have the same data domains. Also, A intersection B can be represented in the form of set difference like this. That is the first relation minus the set difference of first and second relation. All right. I hope that this was clear and that this video helped you understand the concept of intersection in relational algebra. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe for more content. Thank you so much for watching.